Human nature does not obey the laws of politics.
When filmmaker James DeMonaco and his longtime production partner, Sebastian Lemercier, started working on an X-rated treatise on violence, they had no idea they would eventually conceive of The Purge. The Purge franchise felt like it existed wholly in the realm of fiction. Beginning in 2013, the series, about an annual 24-hour holiday from society's civil anti-violence laws, has evolved from an indie, high-concept, sci-fi horror outing into a topical commentary on the rule of law in the United States. And the fifth and final chapter in the series, The Forever Purge, is due in theaters on July 9th, 2021. Let's see the 10 theories about The Forever Purge. Number 10, the title. The Purge series brought an entirely new idea to the world of horror films, and through several installments of the film series, we have seen a lot of changes to how the idea developed in the fictional world. Now it looks like we're finding out the title of the next film coming our way, and based on the title, The Purge could be a regular part of daily life in the movies. The films of the franchise have always kept things rather simple when it comes to titles. THR reporter Chris Parker broke the news and is speculating as to what the title could mean. According to him, we could be seeing The Purge as a regular part of daily life during the new film. In case you didn't know, the premise behind the series is that for 12 hours, once a year, all crime, including murder, rape, theft, and everything else, is completely legal. Sources claim that the film takes The Purge out of its usual metropolitan settings while still dealing with class and race issues in the way the previous films have. Even though The Forever Purge is a name that is not amazingly informative about the plot, but it definitely sounds cool, right? In late 2018, series creator James DeMonaco confirmed that The Forever Purge would be the last of the big screen sequels, saying, "I think it's a great way to end it all. We want to end it all, I think, in this one, and I'm very excited. When I came up with the idea and pitched it to everybody, they seemed psyched, and I think it will be a really cool ending. How we take this one home." Number 9, racial injustice.
Do not purge!
Do not purge!
8 years later, The Purge has gone from horrifying fantasy to horrifying analog for reality. But of course, if you are in the business of making Purge movies, you try not to stand still when the real world changes around you, right? You have to adapt and continue the story in a way that resonates. And throughout the Purge franchise, we have watched the films tackle racism, income inequality, and even presidential elections. The Forever Purge would do wise to address this timely topic in some form or fashion. Real footage captured from ordinary citizens could be used to depict untoward police activity and widespread protests in the streets. Body cam found footage from police officers could also be incorporated in a gritty, handheld manner. Number 8. White supremacy. Just so we touched on the topic of racial injustice, The Forever Purge could very well feature a white supremacy plotline in which aggrieved Americans attempt to take out their ire on minority populations. Well, it's an indecently real idea fostered by the current political climate. Of course, the white supremacists would end up being the main villains, as the annual purge allows righteous citizens to exact justified vengeance if need be.
Like us, we don't survive tonight!
Number 7. Border immigration. Given the large Latin cast that includes Ana de la Reguera, Veronica Falcon, Tinoch Huerta, Yomiri Cruz, Emily Trujillo, and many more, it is quite probable that The Forever Purge will deal with the salient issue of American immigration at the southern border. The theory is strengthened by Cruz listed as a Latinx anchor, Baker Wiles as an anti-purge protester, and Mark Krennic playing a New Founding Fathers of America soldier. Throw in Mexican director Everardo Gout, and this theory becomes pretty airtight.
Blessed be our new founding fathers and America, a nation reborn.
Number 6. America's latest situation. At the end of the Purge election year, anti-Purge politicians Charlie Rohn succeeds in becoming president, seemingly spelling the demise of Purge Night for good. However, violent protests by supporters of the NFFA were happening, suggesting a possible civil war being imminent. While the Purge 5 story is still being kept tightly under wraps, even though it's supposed to release this summer, The Forever Purge's title suggests that not only did some kind of civil war come to pass, but that America now finds itself in an unrelenting state of purge-like conditions, with the pro-NFFA forces trying to make Purge Night last the whole year. If that's the case, it seems quite likely that the other nations of the world will still decide to isolate an America infested with violence and uncertainty, cutting off travel to the US and possibly ending diplomacy and trade as well. After all, when everything is chaotic, would there even be a functioning government to negotiate with? In the Forever Purge, the US may just find itself living inside a huge version of John Carpenter's Escape from New York, with America's mainland having become an unintentional prison for its inhabitants. At least, until things are back under control, which actually could take many years. Number 5. COVID Pandemic. Since the Forever Purge was shut down this past summer due to the global COVID-19 outbreak, it only makes sense that Gout and DeMonaco reference it in some way. Well, setting the Purge amid a global pandemic is not only a great idea on its face, but the current circumstance makes it completely believable. Imagine the sheer logistics of holding a Purge holiday during this current medical condition. All of the masks, the social distancing, the risks of bodily contact, and the dire consequences of such would add such a fascinating and refreshing sparkle to the franchise formula, as well as to the viral outbreak subgenre. Number 4. Cast. Over the years, the Purge franchise has been able to attract some seriously talented actors to perform the material, including Ethan Hawke, Lena Headey, Michael K. Williams, Frank Grillo, and Marissa Tomei.
The benefit of acting violently without worry of consequence, that's a freeing violence.
One thing that seems to be different with the Forever Purge, however, is that it doesn't seem to have the same kind of star power going. Unless there is a star that the production is hiding, it looks like the cast of the new movie is exclusively filmed with up-and-comers, with the most notable names being character actor Will Patton, Nacho Libre's Ana de la Reguera, and True Detective's Levin Rambin. Number 3. Out of the City. With themes concerning class warfare and wealth disparity, the Purge movies to date have well-utilized metropolitan environments for the various stories. But it looks like things are going to be changing up a bit in the Forever Purge. While details have been kept to a minimum, it has been confirmed by the trades that the developing sequel will be changing things up for the fifth feature and will be moving away from urban areas. Whether this means that they will be going to the suburbs, like the first Purge, or perhaps somewhere brand new is currently unknown at this time, but you can be sure that we are all excited to find out. Number 2. Foreign Attack. One cheesily patriotic Forever Purge idea might include bands of American denizens set to do violence against one another on the annual holiday, only to redirect their energy to fend off a foreign attack of some kind. Perhaps terrorists? If not a full-fledged act of war, one idea could include a building being infiltrated by a violent terrorist group just as the Purge begins, where everybody suddenly turns into John McCain and mercilessly makes the terrorists die hard. What do you think?
May God be with you all.
Number 1. Purge on a plane. One surefire way to introduce rolling laughter from the audience would be to set the Purge on an airplane. Imagine if the annual law was extended to the air and sea, thereby allowing those in flight to participate in the lawless tradition with fellow passengers. A situation could be conjured in which, due to the intense violence on the ground, a gigantic airplane is forced to remain in the skies until it's safe to land. The franchise has spawned 3 more films and a television series, each centered around a unique aspect of the dystopian nightmare introduced in the first film. The Purge Anarchy and The Purge Election Year are the only 2 films to feature the same cast. The fourth film, The First Purge, acts as a prequel centered around the first time the titular event took place. While not necessarily critical hits, the low-budget films have been a smash at the box office. And with this fifth film, screenwriter James DeMonaco is looking to bring the franchise to a close. The Purge franchise looks to continue that trend with the latest entry. Seeing as the Forever Purge won't answer all the questions the first Purge left unanswered, DeMonaco is starting with a fresh slate going into the final film. Still, most of the Purge franchise entries have mainly been self-contained, save for the interconnected 2 films. This gives the final movie a reset that will allow a new story to be told while still giving viewers everything they want from a Purge movie. Creepy masks, political commentary, and all the other franchise hallmarks. The Forever Purge will have to do one thing, though. It must up the ante on the action and mayhem to bring the violent series to a fitting conclusion. From what DeMonico has said, it sounds like it will do just that. Do you have any theories about the Forever Purge that you want to share with us? Let us know in the comments down below. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on your post notifications so you never miss a video from us. If you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching.